Scientists around the world have their eyes turned to the sun this week as it reveals a massive active region that could affect us here on Earth. And here joining us from NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, is Dr. Holly Gilbert. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So what is a sunspot and what makes this one so special?
Sunspots are these dark regions on the sun where magnetic fields are bundled together, and it creates such a strong magnetic field that light and heat cannot cross it, so it appears dark relative to the surrounding area. And the particular sunspot region that we're interested right now is the largest that we've seen in 24 years.
Fascinating. So why do we want to learn more from this sunspot?
Sunspots are regions where solar storms originate, so basically where space weather originates. It's important to study these things because they have flares that are associated with them and these bigger storms called coronal mass ejections. So by studying the sunspot region itself and how it evolves, we will understand more about how solar flares are created and when they will impact the Earth.
So will this affect us here on Earth?
We don't know yet. It's possible that it will in the next week because it's still going to be on the side of the sun facing us. It may be associated with these mass ejections, and if they're directed towards the Earth, they can interact with the Earth's magnetic field and cause problems with our satellites, our power grids, our technology. We're protected on the surface from that magnetic field of the Earth and the atmosphere, but our technology is susceptible to these types of storms.
Neat. So what is NASA doing to study sunspots?
Well, we have our eye on the sun all the time, and so we're watching this particular sunspot along with our partners at NOAA. We have a mission called the Solar Dynamics Observatory, which images the sun all the time, and we also have a fleet of missions that not only look at the sun, but study what's happening here near the Earth as well as throughout the solar system. In fact, we have a new mission that we're about to launch next year that are four identical spacecraft. This is called MMS, and those four spacecraft will be inside the Earth's magnetic field, basically taking measurements of these processes that create the solar flares on the sun. But these processes happen near the Earth, they also happen on the sun and throughout the universe. So by studying them near us in our laboratory of the Earth, we can understand better how they happen.
Great. Where can we go to learn more?
You can go to our website to find out a lot more about our missions and lots of images, nasa.gov/sunearth.
Dr. Holly Gilbert, thank you so much.
Thank you.